Is my mic? Oh, good morning, DrupalCon. Look at this.
Good morning.
Hello.
Hey, so thank you for getting out of bed. This has got to be a record for the number of people who are here before the session got started, which is awesome. So you get to see the jokes at the beginning.
That's right.
We have crowdsourced, that's kind of the fashion this year, we've crowdsourced our opening session. We have a number of guests who we will get to one by one in a moment. Thank you all for getting out of bed as well. Very, very quickly, welcome to DrupalCon. Who's at their very first DrupalCon? Who's at their, wow, keep your hands up. Good. Who's at your very first Drupal community event? Wow, thank you so much. Welcome to our community. This is just the baseline of how we do things. Everything else gets a little bit weirder, so.
So my name is Robert Douglas. This is Jam Jeffrey McGuire. And our show today is the history of DrupalCon, told by the people who are actually there and for whom DrupalCon changed their life. So it's people like this that go to DrupalCon and have life-changing experiences.
Oh, and this one time at Drupal Camp, I kind of hacked core and killed a kitty.
Excuse me?
What? You don't think I know how to hack Drupal core? That's half of what Drupal Camp is, hack ed. So are we gonna scrum soon? Because I'm getting kind of antsy.
We all know the feeling. So, for those of you who don't know the history of DrupalCon, it began in 2005, not so far from here, in Antwerp, where we had the first DrupalCon, and I'm going to tell the first DrupalCon changed my life story. DrupalCon changed my life because I showed up in Antwerp and it was only 2 days long, there were only 26 people there, and at one point, I had lunch with Dries, who created Drupal. And as we were walking back to the venue talking about how I hate my Java job, he said, you know, Robert, somebody ought to write a book about Drupal. I'll do it, I said. And from that moment, DrupalCon had changed my life because actually Dries hooked me up with a publisher, and then a week later I was writing a Drupal book, and it was A, hard work, and B, it helped put Drupal on the map and helped give me a career in Drupal, and I could quit my day job doing crappy Java web development and do Drupal full-time. So Drupal changed my life, DrupalCon.
And thank you, Robert Douglas, for the very first Drupal book.
Sure. Now, another person who couldn't be here today, for whom DrupalCon changed their life, was Chix, Carolee Negesi. Sorry, Chix, I really can't say your name. And he gave us this testimonial also about Antwerp, about how DrupalCon changed his life.
My first DrupalCon was, well, everybody's first DrupalCon. It was in 2005 in Antwerp. It was the first of three DrupalCons that have completely changed my life, completely. At the time, I was a pretty much broken software developer from Hungary, and in Antwerp, I have found friends from countries that I have just been a tourist before, at best. It was a very eye-opening. It was a new perspective. And also, at this DrupalCon, after lunch, I have asked Dries, why don't we have a security at drupal.org email address, perhaps just an alias to somebody. Well, my advice is to be very careful when you are asking something like that from me. It's a slightly deeper in delegating. So 2 months later, I have found myself as the founding leader of the security team. That was a big, big change.
So, it's a common theme. Also at that DrupalCon was Neil Drum. How did DrupalCon change your life, Neil?
It was really when Drupal kind of turned into a career for me. I'd recently dropped out of college, and going back you know, after I had worked at Civic Space for a bit, would have been a reasonable thing to do. But, you know, it showed me that Drupal is something I could make a career out of, and, you know, I've stayed in the community ever since.
Thank you. Woo! Soon after that was the DrupalCon in Vancouver 2006. Where are you going? Oh, you're... She's changed a lot. And also not here today is Khalid Bahialdin, for whom DrupalCon changed his life.
My name is Khalid Bahialdin, and I've been with Drupal since 2003, so 11 plus years now. The company that I founded and still run is 2bits.com. That's number 2, and then bits.com, which specializes in performance and hosting for performance. My first DrupalCon was Vancouver 2006, and I just decided to attend because it's kind of close by since I live in Canada. And there I met Dries. I didn't realize how tall he was. And I met Robert Douglas and Kieran Blal and Boris Mann and the other people whom I virtually interacted for during my sheltered existence of 2 years, the childhood in Drupal. Matt Mullenweg from WordPress was there. And I happened to have, you know, Boris Mann invited me to lunch with Matt. Just seeing that there is a big community out there from all over the world, and the fact that this can be the way to have a career in free software. Seeing that there is a community there, there are users out there, then I started to change that into from a first a part-time job and then a full-time job since 2007. I didn't know that being there would turn it into a full-time job for me. People wouldn't realize that attending a DrupalCon would change their life in that way until they go and attend. That's the value of DrupalCon.
So, among many benefactors to the Drupal project that have allowed us to get to this stage of micro-world dominance that we're at, Google has been a friend and helper along the way. And in 2005, Drupal was part of the, for the very first time, of the Google Summer of Code. And the very last place qualifier, Google Summer of Code student, was this woman right here, mentored by this man right here. So,
Angie Byron, how did DrupalCon change your life?
So as Jan mentioned, I came into Drupal and to open source participation in general through Google or through Drupal Summer of Code. And I worked on this module, and then after I was done with the module, kind of Robert kept saying, "Hey, if I give you $500, will you make this theme?" And I was like, "Okay," you know. And it was cool because I actually got to turn Drupal into sort of a freelance gig. But I was really, really, really terrified to go to an event because I thought everyone was like big and smart, and I was just kind of like this kid out of school. But somehow someone convinced me to go to DrupalCon Vancouver, which I did. And it was just amazing because I was really shy and really mousy, which nobody would believe me anymore. And I was sort of like ducked in the corner of the hotel room, sort of working on stuff and hoping someone would see my Google Summer of Code shirt and maybe figure out who I was. And people just came over and they were so friendly and so welcoming and so open. And it was just like mind-blowing to me, and I made tons of friends, and it was just amazing. And then the other pivotal thing from there is, you know, we were in the middle of this Drupal release. It was Drupal 4.7. It was kind of taking a long time. I know this doesn't ring any bells with anybody in the audience. But it was amazing because, you know, again, I kind of had no confidence in myself, but I went to this code sprint that they were having, and Moshe Weitzman's sitting there, like, handing out bugs to people to work on. And I was like, he gave me this bug, and I'm like, "Oh, but dude, this is way over my head." He's like, no, just try it and see what happens. And it was neat because I, in the process of reviewing the patch, I actually found a bug, which I didn't expect, and it actually revealed some darker, deeper issue that we ended up fixing. And so it just felt that empowerment of really, like, helping to make this thing that I loved more awesome and meeting tons of awesome people. So, and to this day, we're still staying up all night working on code. So there you go.
Yeehaw. Thank you, Angie.
Hey, so... Brussels Brussels 2006 was very much like this con. I showed up at the venue for my very first DrupalCon, and for registration, I handed Dries a 20-euro note, and I got handed a T-shirt, and I was in. And yeah, I went to a bunch of sessions, and at some point, my brain was full. But DrupalCon Brussels changed my life, because up until then, I had been in one career that I really loved as a performing musician, and one career that I was good at but I didn't really enjoy, which is writing and translation. And I was looking for a way to support my family better. And I was learning Drupal because it looked promising, and it was hard, but it seemed exciting. And I went and I heard what was going on with it. I saw MTV UK was there, right? And it was this real thing, and it was amazing. And I wasn't able to go to another Drupal event for 18 months, but by that time, because the inspiration that I got in Brussels, beginning of 2008, I started working full-time as a Drupal consultant, and by late summer of 2008, I was employee number 18 at Acquia, so DrupalCon very seriously changed my life.
Awesome. So the next DrupalCon after that was DrupalCon Sunnyvale, and sorry about
quite
that,
dumb.
Dries. Dries Buterre, how did DrupalCon change your life?
Sure. I mean, actually, I would say more than one DrupalCon changed my life, but I was asked to talk about Sunnyvale. And so in Sunnyvale 2007, I believe we were trying to get Drupal 5 released, but I could be wrong about the version. And I was there, you know, working with the core developers, and a man called Jay Batson, he started bugging me, literally. Like, he wanted to have, like, 30 minutes with me. And I'm like, nope, I'm here working on Drupal 5 with the core developers. I have no time to talk to you. And so he kept bugging me, through email, like, showing up in person. And I kept pushing him off. And eventually I said, sure, I'll have breakfast with you. And, Jay and I, we talked about starting a company together. And, we literally started dating, I guess, you know, at that time. And roughly 9 months later, Acquia was born.
Thank you. Come here. Now, Dries, that's a beautiful story, Dries. However, I have to say that Jam and I have always imagined that it happened a little bit differently. Maybe more like this.
Gotta make the sounds.
Oh, sorry.
Okay.
There is no escape. You have only begun. Hold up. This thing is awful.
Playing the role of Jay Batson is Darth Vader on the left. Can we have the mic on, please? Is it on?
Or we'll just talk really loud. So, you build this enormous planet-destroying machine, and it's always the little things, you know? My toilet backed up last night, too. Really? All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
You have only begun to realize your power. Join me, and I will complete your training.
But I wanted to pick up some power converters at Tashi Station.
I just remembered my line. If you only knew the power of the corporate side. Gabor never told you what happened at DrupalCon Barcelona.
Wait,
there was a DrupalCon in Barcelona? I mean, when did that happen? How many people even showed up?
Dude, it was in 2007. It was awesome. There were like 400 people there. You really should have come.
That's not true! That's impossible!
Search your feelings. You know it to be true.
My hand!
Dries, you can destroy the WordPress. They have foreseen it. It is your destiny. Join me, and we will rule the internet as CEO and CTO.
I'll never join you.
I'll give you stock options and a very nice health plan.
That actually sounds pretty good.
Oh, well, all right then.
Same, bravo.
Now we know. So after that, Barcelona, as was just mentioned, with 400 people there, Dries obviously not one of them. This person, Kerry Gordon, his life was changed at DrupalCon Barcelona.
Hi, I'm Kerry Gordon, and I run a company called the Cherry Hill Company. Most of what we do now is develop web-based systems, and our weapon of choice now is Drupal. I started doing this about 20 years ago when I walked into a library and they had a computer but didn't know how to turn it on. I learned Drupal by reading the code, which at that time was doable because it wasn't like quite as humongous as it is now, although I still think that's the best way to learn Drupal. We got a client in 2006, early 2007. Their requirement is that they supported 11 languages, I18N, internationalization and localization out of the box weren't working for them mid-2007. And that point, I think we're up to Drupal 4.7.2. With the internationalization, we were running into a brick wall. And I knew that DrupalCon was coming up. I'd never even thought about going to DrupalCon, but I knew that DrupalCon was coming up in Barcelona. So I knew that Jose Riera was going to be involved, and I knew that Gabor would be there. I didn't know them other than names at that point. So I said, okay, I can buy a ticket, get on the plane, go to Barcelona, you know, for a few days. It was all right until I actually walked into DrupalCon. That's when I got in trouble because, you know, I started meeting people. First time it was Gabor. I met everyone else. I looked around and said, we got to do one of these in Los Angeles. Introduced myself to Dries, say, we got to do one of these in Los Angeles. And magically, I guess a year and a half later, I didn't get to do a DrupalCon in Los Angeles, but I became the DrupalCon event director. That's what I got out of saying, maybe I can get this question answered by going to DrupalCon. That's what DrupalCon gave to me.
Right. So next up is DrupalCon Boston 2008. Another video contestant whose life was changed. I'm introducing Doug Van.
But DrupalCon Boston 2008 was towards the latter portion of my first 100 days in Drupal. Josh was aware of the project I was working on and that I had a team working on it. So I showed him the code that night. He tells me, hey, dude, your core is hacked. So I actually made a phone call that evening from the Uber dinner and fired the team that was working on this big, huge social network project. Oh, it changed our life. I mean, we were doing Drupal wrong. We were so happy to get the benefits of Drupal. And who isn't happy to get the benefits of Drupal? But if it's the benefit of Drupal being hacked, That's not really the benefit you're looking for. DrupalCon changed my life in that it put me at the right time at the right place with the right people, and I was able to connect with people who knew the situation better than I did. To all you would-be core hackers that are hacking away at core, do you really want to kill kittens that way? It's just so bad. It's just so sad. The Drupal API is so accessible and extendable. There's no reason to hack core. Please don't.
Oh.
Let's go back a slide, shall we? Oh, no, go forward one, Rob.
Okay, we'll do it that way.
Nick Feinhoff.
How did DrupalCon...
Nick Feinhoff.
How did DrupalCon change your life?
Before I can tell that story, I have to go a little bit back, like 1 week back, more or less. And just the moment before that, I was looking for my first job, the first thing that really should have changed your life, or the next step in your career. And I found a company, and they advertised with, oh, we play the radio, and you can go travel. And that company was called Crimson back in the time. Now it's Wundercrowd, I think. I'm sure. And they sent me the first week of my job to Szeged, and it was full of people, and it was so overwhelming. Same as Jam, I fell asleep in a session because it was too much. And that really changed my life because I wasn't as outspoken as I was. I didn't travel as much, and now I've lived in Spain doing Drupal, lived in Portugal doing Drupal, lived in the States doing Drupal, and I now helped Acquia open up an office in Ghent in my hometown, and it really changed my life. Thank you.
Stella Power, how did DrupalCon change your life?
Back in 2008, I was working in IT. I wasn't particularly happy with my job, and I was doing Drupal as a hobby, just for fun. So people have been telling me about Boston and Barcelona. I was like, okay, I'll go along and see what the whole fuss is about. So I took some time off work. I went to Szeged, and I was simply blown away. Blown away by the community, the people I met. I met Webchick. I met Addison, Mary. I gave a session on Coder with Doug Green, who had been my mentor. So it was just an amazing experience. And I went home next week. I quit my job. So
woohoo!
Quit your job.
So I started a Drupal agency in Ireland called Anartech, and it's very successful, and we're over 10 people now, so it really did change my life.
Bravo! Woo-hoo! Fast forwarding to 2009, our next contestant, also by video, is Brian Shensky. Brian, how did DrupalCon change your life?
Well, my name is Brian Shensky. I heard that Drupal was something to look at, and I very quickly noticed the similarities between SQL forms back in the day and the things that I was doing inside of Drupal. And I said to myself, by God, this thing has legs. And luckily, in 2010, DC was close enough to my home in Michigan that I could make the trek. And it felt like I was going home all over again. It felt like I was in the company of people who really understood the market. They understood the mission of the technologies. They understood each other. That feeling of community came on so strong in DC for me that I knew that I had found where I wanted to take my career next. But the one thing that stuck with me that sealed the deal for me was at the very, very end of the entire week, where we all gathered on the steps of the conference center and took the group photo. That was something that was truly unique. To be able to see that picture and see myself in that picture, that was something that was tangible proof that I was part of the Drupal community, and that meant a lot to me.
Thank you, Brian. Matthew Radcliffe, how did DrupalCon change your life?
So today, I work with Drupal, and I love being a core mentor at DrupalCon. It's a great feeling, and you'll often find me on Saturday just working on Drupal in a coffee house. And it all began at DrupalCon DC for me at the second session I attended. It was called Drupal Sucks by Jeff Eaton of Lolabot fame and his guest host, Earl Miles, with a hand puppet, injecting comments about how there's a module for that and whatnot. And so I learned that, you know, we come to DrupalCon to share what we know, whether it's from the features module or the patterns module and the debates that we had at DrupalCon DC. And then finally, it culminates in this day of sprinting at the end. And now it's a full week, but back then it was just a day. And so DrupalCon inspired me to contribute back to the open source community. And it also gave me this crippling coffee addiction.
And you're even wearing your DrupalCon Washington DC t-shirt. Yay. So, not on the slides, but here in flesh and blood, Jacob and Emily, how did DrupalCon change your life?
So my first DrupalCon was in 2006 in Vancouver, and there's many ones that make changes. But I think in D.C., 2009 was the biggest one, and it all started with a camera, a menu, and Doug Van.
Although really it started with Morton. Me and my friends were at the D.C. Convention Center, and we had no idea where to go. And Morton, he flagged everyone down, come to the after conference restaurant. So we went there. And there Doug Van found us looking for a seat and said, here, let me introduce you to Jacob.
So as everyone knows, there's only like two menus in a restaurant for like 100 people. So I was taking pictures of these things, the menu, and sharing her camera around. And she liked my camera, I guess.
It was really cute.
So after we didn't see each other for most of the conference, but then we got to see each other at the Lullabot after party. And we talked Drupal most of the night. And then... 4 years later?
So 4 years later, our wedding website was called Drupal Camp Wedding, and my bridesmaid, who is definitely not a Drupalist, had everyone there toast to that Drupal thing.
Woo! That Drupal thing! Woo!
Hey, so I think we also have a, I think we have a new definition for we talked about Drupal all night.
David Stolein, how did DrupalCon change your life?
Hey, so this is a playing hooky story, right?
Yeah, it definitely is. So in 2009, I was working at a small design shop in Washington, D.C., and I'd left the train to walk to work, and I saw a sign for DrupalCon, and you know, I'm thinking, oh, I've heard of Drupal. I installed it once, and it wasn't that great, and so I sat at my desk. You know, a few hours go by, I convinced a coworker to come with me to just check it out over lunch. So me and this coworker, we didn't have a ticket, so we just kind of walked in, and I guess security was pretty tight, but I didn't really notice that. So we walked in, I attended a few sessions, we stayed basically the rest of the day. So after that, I came back to my desk to get my things, because I obviously left them there for whatever reason. And pretty much overnight, we'd taken our custom-developed CMS and started leveraging Drupal right then. After that, I quit my job. I found a job working on the team that was job. Bringing. There's a theme here.
Quit your job. Quit your job.
And I started working on the team that was bringing WhiteHouse.gov to Drupal. So within a really short period of time, I had a full-time, pretty prominent Drupal job.
From playing hooky to WhiteHouse.gov. Woo! Congratulations, David. Thank you.
Thank you, David. So how many of you in the last couple of months have had a bucket of very cold ice and water poured over your heads?
The ALS ice bucket challenge. Anybody did it? Anybody?
That
anybody
is really see one? Weird.
Do you
Who's
have any idea what thing? We're talking about? Oh, great. So, Jam, I had this idea about how we could kind of speed up Drupal 8. You know, it's a little bit late.
We need to get it out the
we
door.
We need to get out the door. But the problem is there are bugs. There are so many damn bugs.
Right. So we have a challenge for this.
Okay. And this is going to go viral, and you're all going to do it, and we're going to get Drupal 8 out the door.
Hello. My name is Robert Douglas, and I'm here today to take the Bug Elimination Challenge. To raise awareness for too many bugs in Drupal 8, I am now going to eat this here plate of bugs. Too many bugs. Too many bugs. We've got to get rid of these bugs. So as you can see, all the bugs are gone, every last one of them, and I have done my duty for Drupal 8. Now, I hereby nominate three people to also do your part for Drupal 8. You are Tom Erickson, Dries Bitart, and Josh Koenig. You have 24 hours. Have fun. What the hell?
Get
out.
There he is.
Get out. Is there something on my back? Is there something on my back?
No.
Oh.
Is it in your shirt?
It's in my shirt. He's in my shirt. He's in my shirt.
He's in your shirt.
He's in my shirt.
Oh, there he goes.
One less bug.
Never tasted so good. Paris, 2009. Who was there, by the way? All right, great. Matt Silden, how did DrupalCon change your life?
When we went there, we planned to film a couple of really silly episodes of the DrupalCon going down to Paris and stopping at various places in Europe, like a roadshow. And doing so, while planning, that was the first time that we had contact with the Drupal Association and Dries himself. And the amazing thing for us was that the organization and Dries was so accessible and open, and we could say, like, we want to come home to your house in Antwerp and fool around with your kids and put it on video and show it to people, and we want to take part in the opening ceremony. And all the answers we got was, that's okay. So we did, and today we're a diamond sponsor of this DrupalCon.
Thank you. Anya, Johannes, how did DrupalCon change your life?
So today we're at DrupalCon as one of Germany's biggest Drupal companies, but it wasn't always like this. We were the local user group in Hanover when we decided to build a company, but we had one problem. We had no name.
And then one day we decided, the whole team, to go to DrupalCon Paris. Had a wonderful time there, met a lot of Drupalistas, drank a lot of beer, and did also some nice sightseeing with our travel guide, Robert. And there was the next problem we had. The problem was that Anya, Mirko, Stefan and me had some crazy names, and Robert couldn't keep them.
I just couldn't say Stefan and Stefan the right way.
Especially Stefan and Stefan. And he also didn't distinguish their faces for any reason. I don't know why.
I was calling them all Stefan by the end, even Anya.
So we tried to make it easier for him, and then decided to simply rename Stefan and Stefan, and named them Günther and Paul. And that was a nice solution. We went home from DrupalCon Paris, and then some weeks later, we had the solution to our first problem too. We had a name for our company, and now it's called Und Paul.
Und Paul. Thank you.
Quit your job. Quit your job.
Josef Wiener Schnitzel Dabrening, how did DrupalCon change your life?
So my first DrupalCon was Copenhagen, and before that I spent a whole year working in Central America as a volunteer. and I had some great mentors that explained me how to contribute to Drupal, because I was using it for the website there, but I didn't know how to fix things that were broken in Drupal. So this hand-holding enabled me to really feel be able to contribute back by writing patches and doing presentations. Then I came back to Austria, met the great Austrian Drupal community, and all together we got to DrupalCon Copenhagen, which was just overwhelming. In particular, I remember Amitabh's session about organic groups, which was hilarious, and you should see the video. So, for example, Angela Merkel, she would say that the world needs rules in that video. And that's also true for Drupal 8, by the way. So that was my first DrupalCon. I got hired then, and since then I'm attending all the DrupalCons in Europe. Have a job and have a good life.
Thank you. So we're going to fast forward to San Francisco a little bit, which also changed Doug Van's life.
Now we're at DrupalCon San Francisco 2010. But if you want to hear a second story of DrupalCon changing Doug Van's life, it's all the press and visibility I got from standing up there with this 15-year-old kid on an accordion and Jeff Robbins on vocals, just wailing out the Drupal song. That was a lot of great press and a lot of great fun. Definitely a life-changing experience.
Dude, when Robert Douglas says record the Drupal song, you record the Drupal song.
When you've got a website, you need a system to manage your content, Drupal. When you need to build a web application, you gotta download Drupal. Drupal, 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 Drupal.
Thanks, Doug.
Okay, I want to know.